Let's begin. Hello everyone. In this video tutorial, we are going to talk about getPivotData function. The Excel getPivotData function can query a pivot table and retrieve specific data based on the pivot table structure instead of cell reference. Here is the syntax. In this worksheet, I have prepared a pivot table based on this table. My main goal is to extract this data from the pivot table and put them in separate cells. This will help me to be flexible with my chart design or use the data to complex formulas. So I'm going to show you a few tricks and hopefully you will love the function as it can be a great tool. Let's click on I4 cell and start typing. Equal get pivot data. Now look at the syntax first. The first argument is data field and the second is pivot table. And then we have field and item, which are optional. The data field can be total or sum of total. Then pivot table is simply a cell located inside the pivot table. But it's better to use the top left, because this isn't going to disappear when we shrink or change the pivot table. So type I17 and press F4 for absolute reference. Enter. Nice. The next example is to find the total for pencil. Before we start typing the formula, we have to understand what field and item are. Let's click on pivot table. Here is the field list. The fields you can choose from are these: order date, region, customer, item, etc. The pencil is an item. The getPivotData can return a value for a field that exists on pivot table and is visible. Now we are ready to type. With similar way typing. Let's say I change the layout of this pivot table by adding units. I don't see a difference in my results. But if I will remove item from rows, I will get errors everywhere. Remember what I've told you. GetPivotData can return a value for a field that exists on pivot table and is visible. Another trick is to use drop-down lists. For example, let's quickly create a list of regions here. Now, delete K3 cell, go to Data tab, Data Validation, select List. The source is these cells. And OK, edit formula, and instead of West, type in K3. Great, look at the results. So, that is using cell reference in your getPivotData function to update upon selections dynamically. This tool is excellent for dashboards reports or any reports. Also, pivot tables are more efficient than arrays formulas when working with large data tables. And when using the getPivotData formula, you can leverage the power of pivot tables. Thanks for watching.